Okay, today y'all, we are going to learn how to make this gorgeous little flower cup cozy. And there's a flower on each side, and there's a button in the middle. Okay? So I'm going to show you how to get this on your cup. Let's get started. Okay, since it's fall, we're going to start with brown in the center. You are going to do your magic loop. And once again, if you don't know how to do this, I have a video that shows it a little bit slower and more detailed than this. There you go with your magic loop. Okay, now we are going to chain three. And we're going to put 11 stitches. So we'll have 12 counting our chain three as the beginning one. For the total. Okay, there's 2, 3, you're actually doing 11, but your chain three counts as your first one. So I usually count this as 12. You're doing a double stitch. Okay, you're just gonna continue with a double. You go loop under, go through the loop, pull through, grab your yarn, pull through two, grab your yarn, pull through two. Okay, let's do that a few more times. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9. We need 3 more. So we have 1, 2, and 3. Okay, there's your 12 stitches. Then you're going to take your tail, you're going to pull it tight to the center so you have nothing in the middle. You have a little tiny hole, and when we tie that off, we'll completely close that up, okay? Then you're going to go in, you can go in this full stitch if you like, because that makes it a little easier. If you want it to look completely uniform, you're going to go in this top stitch on this side, and then on the other side. It's a little tricky to get through both of those. So you've got your two threads there, and you're going to just slip it together. There you go. Okay, this is our little center circle. This is all you're going to do for the brown. So you're going to cut it off, and then you're going to pull it in. Tie it off here. Okay, now we're going to sew these two pieces in. Just make sure you get it where it hides good. I like to twist the needle so it will go through easy. It just makes it a little easier for me. Just twist it and then you pull it out. And we're going to cut this off right up against it. Okay? And then we're going to do the same thing with this one. Okay, here we are. We made our two circles. Now we're going to make our poofy flower. We're going to do this a little easier way to attach your yarn. You stick your needle through the thread, and you grab your thread, your new thread, and you pull it through. That's all you do. Now we're going to do chain four, because this is a triple stitch, okay? So when you pull that tight, it's going to be right there, and it's fine. When you tie it in, it'll be knotted in just perfect without a little knot, okay? So we're going to do triple stitches this time. You're going to loop around your needle twice, or your hook, and you're going to do 3 in one spot, okay? You've got 4 pieces of thread on your needle. You're going to loop under, grab, come through 2, just like you do for the double stitch, but there's going to be one more, okay? And you did four single crochets, or four chains, excuse me, for your first stitch. We're going to do that again. Loop under twice, go in the same hole, pull through, go through two, go through two, and go through two. And if you'll notice, this is the pumpkin spice again. So this will match your other, pumpkin coasters and your pumpkin, if you've made the same thing. So I'm working on the same skein of yarn as well. Now after your three triple stitches, you do two chains. Then you're going to repeat the triple stitches in the next, very next stitch. And you're going to do three of those again. One, two, three. Loop under twice. Go through. Pull through. Pull through two. Grab your yarn, pull through two. Grab your yarn, pull through two. And you repeat again. Okay. This one's a little trickier. I would say this is a little bit above beginner, so intermediate. Okay. You've got two bunches for the petals, and you're going to do two more chains. So we're going to make our third petal by doing three triple stitches. One, two, three. Two loops under. One, two, three. Two loops under. One, two, three. Okay. And we're going to repeat this all the way around. So when you're done, you're going to have three bunches, or 12 bunches of three. This is your petal of your flower. So you want 12 of these when you're done. So pause the video here. I'm going to go ahead and make both of these, and you can catch up and do yours while you have it paused. I'll come back in just a minute. Okay. When you get to the end of your 12 petals, you should have it looking just like this, about. And we're going to go in the very top, one, two, three, four, of this other petal over here, okay? And then you're going to slip it together by pulling your yarn straight through. So your petals are separated by two chains on every single one. Okay, you've got 12 clusters of three triple crochets. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go do the second one and come right back. This is a good place for you to pause it and make your second petals. Okay, here we are with our two flowers complete. And we're going to start in the next step. You're going to go through any one of these holes. Okay. And you're going to do your slip knot over your finger, or however you do it. Leave enough yarn there to tie in. Okay, and we're going to slip it right in here. And then we're going to do a chain one. Okay, then we're going to do three single crochets. One, two, three, all in the same hole, okay? We're gonna work mostly in these holes. Then you're gonna chain one. You're turning this into a granny square, okay? You're gonna chain one, and then you're gonna do a half double, which is, flip under your yarn, go through the hole, loop under, pull through, loop under, pull through all three. Okay, then you're going to loop under, go through the hole, you're going to do a double. Pull through two, Then you're going to do a triple. You're going to loop under twice, pull through, pull through two. I'm missing something there. Okay, let's do that double again, that triple. Two loops, go through the hole, pull through, loop under, pull through two, loop under, pull through two, loop under, pull through two. Then you're gonna chain two because this is your corner of your granny square, okay? I know it looks a little funny right now, but just keep going. We're gonna do a triple. Loop under twice, pull through, into your two, two, and two. Now you're gonna do a double, loop under once, go through, pull through once, two and two. Then you're gonna loop under, go through, pull through, and you're gonna do all three. You're doing a half double. So what you've got here is all in one space because that is your corner, okay? So then you're gonna chain one and you're gonna go into three singles, one, two, and three. And that happens in the next opening. You're gonna do the same thing again. You're gonna chain one, go in the next opening and do three single crochets. One, two, and three. Okay, then you're going to chain one again. Then you're at your next corner. Now don't feel bad if you ended up with 11 petals because I did that on one of my first ones. I had 11 petals and so this part didn't work out. I had to pull the whole thing out. So make sure you have 12 petals before you start this part. But since this is your next corner, okay, there I did my chain one. You're gonna do a half double, pull through once, pull through all three. You're gonna do a double, loop under, pull through two, and pull through two. Then you're gonna do a triple, loop under twice, go through and pull it through, pull through two, two, and two. Since this is the next corner, you're gonna chain two. Then you're gonna reverse the process and do a triple, a double, and a half double. And there's your next corner. Now you're gonna chain one. In the next hole, you're gonna do three singles. Then you're gonna chain one. In the next hole, you're gonna do three singles. One, two, and three. Then you're gonna chain one and you've got your next corner. So you're gonna start with your half double, your double, and then your triple. Once again, since a corner, we are going to chain two. And then we're gonna start back with the triple, all in the same hole. Your double, and then your half double. Okay, so here we are with three corners. Let's get out just a little bit here. We have three corners. We've got one more corner left and these two sides to finish. So we're going to chain one and do three singles here. chain one again. In the next hole, you do three more singles. Okay, then you're going to chain one, and what have we got? We have the corner. So we're going to half double, double, and triple. Chain two, triple, double, and half double. Then you're going to chain one, and you have one section left. You need two spaces here with your single crochets, so this one gets three single crochets, one chain, and then you slip this together, and your square is complete. There we go. Now we're going to cut this off. Pull that through, pull it tight, and now we're going to weave those two ends in. I'll do that off camera, and I'm also going to stop and catch this one up. So this is a good time to pause the video or backtrack it to the beginning of this section to do your second flower. So I'll be right back. Okay, y'all, just like I told you a few minutes ago, let me see if I can back this up just a little bit. I have 11 petals. Yeah, wah, wah, wah. I have 11 petals, so I'm gonna have to make another flower for the square. But before that happens, I'm gonna go ahead and finish this one. I'm gonna show you how to go ahead and finish it. I'm gonna use it as a coaster for myself, because I don't wanna waste the fact that I've already tied everything in. And once you tie in the ends, you cannot undo your crochet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the same corner in this second stitch here, okay? It's not gonna be perfect. I'm just going to do a half double and a double, two chains, a double and a half double, and one chain, and then slip it together to this other side and make it kind of look like it's a square, okay? So this is not just right, and I really want my coaster or my cup holder to be two exactly. So this is going to be the coaster that goes with the cup holder. So everyone makes mistakes. Trim that off. And I could have pulled it out if I had not already tied in all my ends, but I was not careful to count my petals. So there you go. That is how you improvise with a mistake. And this actually could work, but I'm just going to go ahead and make another one. So I will be right back, and with the magic of the internet, we will finish. Okay, here we are with our two flower squares complete with the corners correct on all four. And here is my little coaster one that has the wrong corner. So that one's a coaster. And since this is a very large size mug, we have to have a little more space than what this square provides. So I'm going to do the next step here. I've got all the ends tied in. And the next step is to take one square, and we are going to do some single crochets on the edging. So just on the bottom, because this square is tall enough for that cup, but it is not long enough yet with the two of them. So we're going to come right here in the very corner. Okay. That is, whoops, that's the wrong one. Yep, don't crochet with your tail. Crochet with the yarn, not the tail. We're gonna come through and we're gonna do one single crochet, one chain, and we're gonna single crochet all the way around, not all the way around, excuse me, all the way across in every stitch. Okay, we're gonna single crochet all the way across to give this some more length. So just go in those stitches the best you can and keep going all the way to the other side. And almost to the end here. Okay, now we're gonna give it one more. So we're gonna chain two and turn our work. You're not gonna go in this one, but you're gonna go in that one because you do want a square corner on this as much as possible. We're gonna single crochet, whoops, all the way across again. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna do this on all the length sides. So I'll show you that in just a second. You wanna do two rows because you need the center to be wider. See how you get here? You're gonna need this side here done as well. And then you're gonna need this side here and this side here. Now this one is gonna take a little extra, a little more than two rows. So we're gonna do three rows here. And there's my dog. Hang on. Okay, here we are with your first flower square. And I have the first two rows on one side. We're gonna put two rows on this side. And then we're going to take this flower square and put two rows and then three rows on this side. So I'll be back when that part is done. Okay, here we are with our extra rows of single crochet on both ends of both flower squares. Now the next step, I left these tails really long, which I probably didn't need to because we're going to crochet this together. So we're going to take, this is kind of the back side, so we're going to do it on the front side because that shows the rib right here. It looks like a ribbing. So what we're going to do is our slip knot. And we're going to get those tails out of there. And we're going to just single slip together. Now you could do a single crochet here if you wanted a larger rib, which actually I'm just gonna do that. So I'll do chain two. I think that's what I did on the first one here in front of me. And we're gonna get this tail inside of our stitches, okay? So you're just gonna do a single crochet all the way across. And you just have to get it up in there and get all of them. There's several ways to do this, but I'm just going to do this with the single crochet. Because this makes it a little bit easier. And I'm going to go, since I'm right here, I'm going to go ahead and cut the tail of this one because it is sewed in with the crochets. With the stitches. It's basically in there. You're not going to find it again. And so let's see. That's another way to hide your tails, is to crochet it under your stitches. And that is that set. We are going to cut that off and pull it through. I've got a lot of tails to stitch in. And see that ribbing there? It's just kind of an extra little, I don't know. I kind of like it on the outside sometimes. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna make our buttonhole. And this one here is what we're gonna do. So you're gonna just kind of guesstimate where the center is. And you're gonna do your slip knot. And then you're gonna go about right here. So you're gonna go in, you need about 5 stitches, 4 or 5 stitches. And so you're gonna go in here. And you're gonna do a chain. You're gonna do some single crochets. Hide your tail. Now when you get to this end of here, you're gonna flip your tail over if you would like to do that and hide it a little bit more, and then pull it through this way. When you're chaining, you're gonna chain 2. Then you're gonna pull it back over here and hide it in these stitches. You can do another single row. Keep your tail up in there. And you cut it off. One before the end, and that way a little tiny thing that sticks out is going to be hidden in the last stitch. You won't even see it. Okay, and then we're going to do chain 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 5. Slip it in this last section here and pull that through. Then you're going to chain 1, turn it over, and you want a single stitch in each one of these because you want it to be sturdy, not just one chain holding it. And then you're going to come down a little bit and slip into there, cut it off, and pull it through. Now I have all these ends to sew in, and there's your buttonhole. Just get a random button and make sure it fits through. Okay, so okay, the last thing to check before you put your button on is to make sure your needle goes through. Because if your needle head is too big to go through your button, you can't do it. So we're going to put our butt right here on this single crochet couple of rows. So first we're going to lock our thread in by doing it just like when you tie it in. You're going to go back and forth a few times. And just don't pull it too tight on that first round or you'll pull it out again and have to start over. Just kind of go in and out and get it on there real good, and then you're going to go up through it. Then you stick your button on and just go through the button just like you're sewing it onto clothing, except it's hard finding the hole. Okay, and you just sew that right on. And I'm going to go 3 times in each side. That's what I did on my other ones. That makes sure it's good and sturdy. Okay? Because you don't want your button popping off on this. There's twice. We're going to go one more time. If I can find the hole. That's the top one. It gets tougher and tougher. Okay, that needle will not go through a third time. So we're going to go through twice. And then we're going to lock it in back here again so the thread doesn't pop out. Which I don't think with that button there's a lot of chance of that, but got to lock it in good. And one more time. I've got all the edges sewed in, not the edges, the tails. All the tails are sewed in. And therefore, we are complete. Y'all, if you sewed, crocheted along with me, you have a beautiful little cup cozy now. And it fits one of these large cups. This is the Cow one from Walmart. I got this as a gift last year. You're gonna wrap it right around here. Let me change the angle. And let's put this through the hole here, through the handle. And I've already got coffee in it, so it's a little bit tricky today while it's full. And you just pop it around that button, and it goes right there. It fits just right on this large cup. So pretty soon we'll have another video with the smaller cup. And this is pumpkin spice yarn, and it's all done. Thanks for watching, and thanks for crocheting with me, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye. Now don't forget, you have a matching coaster to go with your beautiful cup cozy.